Richest person on the world.
Jeff Bezos.
Exactly. Here we go with this next slide, please. So, Zara. It was founded in the year 1975. The very first name of Zara was Zobra, but then it changed to Zara. The founders are Emiko Origeta and Rosalia Mera. The headquarters are at Artizo, and the revenue is 1,29,713 crore. And it, the parent company is Inditex. What is the Inditex? Inditex is a group of a company which holds different brands, and the brands are as follows. Next slide, please. Zara, Bershaka, Massimo Dutti, Pull & Bear, Stradivarius, Zara Home, Oysho, and Uterkyo. Look at it, Zara covers the most of the share. It covers 65%. Next slide, please. Let us know more about Zara. What is Zara? What is Zara? A brand which contains men's clothing, women, kids, and even accessories. Isn't it? It presents you, it gives you confidence, that gives you to walk and present yourself. Next, please. Manufacturing and okay, let me tell you the fact about Zara. Zara creates 12,000 designs per year. 12,000. Whereas the other brand touches the number of 3,000 or 4,000. And in a week, a Zara store reaches, it comes to 2 times the new product has been reached in a store. Next. Non-toxic clothing. The Greenpeace had a dialogue with Zara about the toxic clothing. And in the 9 days, Zara made sure that till 2020, it will make sure that there will be no toxic clothing which will be used in Zara, and they are working on it. Next, please. Main competitors. Surely, when you are in a market, you will definitely have a competitors. And the main competitors are Mango, H&M, and GAP, or Gap, whatever you call it. Next, please. Supply chain. The main success key for the supply chain, I'll explain you. Zara mainly buys only 4 fabric colors, and they have a centralized distribution center which is connected towards by a tunnel, and they have a mono trains in it. And within 5 days, all the process has been taken up from the company to reaching to the suppliers, and the factories can be ordered on the basis. And Zara doesn't believe in advertisement. It believes it has an agent. Though they attend the market, they go to parties, they go to fashion shows, and going over there, they look at the latest trend. And within the 15 days, that trend is converted into design, fashion designers work on it, and it is made available on the store within the 15 days. Yes, within the 15 days. Next. So, the factors which are affecting the business, quality of factor, definitely it is much needed. Economical factor, social factor, and environmental factor. The very basic thing which Zara works on is creating a scarcity. Yes, what it does, it creates the product in a very less amount, and they sell it to the store. They look for the how is working, is it going good, how's the sale of the clothes. They look it for the 1 week. If it's going great, then they make sure that it is there for the 4 week. But if it's not, they cancel the deal there itself. So they are never in loss, or the losses are very minor.
Thank you, Shivam. So, Zara in India. Zara entered Indian market in 2010 with its first outlet in Delhi. Zara operates in India with the joint venture with Tata Group's Trends. So why would Zara need, their question arises, why joint venture? Why Zara needs a joint venture with Tata Group's? Anyone know? Okay, I will tell you. According to the Government of India has a policy, FDI policy, foreign direct investment, in which any foreign company, if want to enter the Indian market, they have to give 49% of their stakes to the indigenous company like Tata. That's why this joint venture happened. Next slide, please. Okay, so this is 49% of Trends Limited, which is of Tata, and the 51% of Intidex for Zara. As we already know, Tata Group is everywhere. Tata Group is everywhere. So, it has some advantages. The joint venture has some advantages as well. It has some disadvantages. Advantages cover, as Tata already have properties in India, it would be easily it would easy to be develop business, to develop infrastructure very easily with less permission, as well as it has disadvantages for the parent company, that is Zara. What is the disadvantages? As 49% of stakes are with Tata, so they have to share some amount of information with Tata, and that information may lead to some leaks in information. Also, when 49% of stakes are given to other company, there is a risk of damaging the brand name. Next slide, please. So, revenue and PAT. So, anyone know PAT? What is the full form of PAT? What, sir? Okay, thank you. Profit after tax. So, according to financial year 2017, the revenue was 1,023 crores in rupees. With a PAT of 47.6 crores. In the next year, that is financial year 2018, it was 1221 crore rupees and with a whooping growth of 73%, that is 82.5 crores. Again, in financial year 2019, there was a drop in PAT, that is 71.4 crores. But still, Zara manages to have the revenue of 1438 crores. Okay. So next slide, please. So the cause of drop in profit due to ever increasing competition by H&M, Gap, and Forever 21, Zara has to give some discounts of 10 to 15% to increase their sales. That lead to. Okay. Next slide, please. These are the competitors. H&M and Gap are the biggest competitor. Though H&M entered in 2015, they already had 40, they already have now 40 stores, outlets in India. Compared to Zara, they only have 22. But still, Zara is leading with 1,438 crore of revenue, sales revenue. Gap is having 13 standalone stores and 15 shops, shopping shops, small shops, with less than 1,000 crore. Okay, next slide, please. So, future challenges. Zara had to face future challenges to grow their infrastructure and everything. As H&M is fastly growing, they have to keep up with them. Also, a Japanese company, Uniqlo, is set to enter in India market with cheaper price and high quality clothes. Next slide, please.